I think I finally found the best AI plugin to use in Obsidian in a way that doesn't take away from the thinking process, but really just augments how we can think with a second brain. So this is the plugin Smart Connections, and it really solves the number one pain point of how can I better connect the notes in my vault. So let me show you how it works and how you can set this up. All right, what we have to do is open up any note. Let me use this one. This is when I was reading the book, The Body. It talked about how the brain is mostly made out of water and the rest is mostly fat and protein. And with such simple substances, water, fat, and protein, and a few other things, that our brain is able to do everything that it can. You know, we can think, we can memorize, we can retrieve, we can see, we can appreciate aesthetics and all of the rest of the good stuff that our brain does. How amazing is that? I found it was interesting that what makes the brain powerful is in the connections and not in the substances, so to speak. So when I was trying to come up with the notes that are connected, my first brain came up with these two. 1 plus 1 doesn't equal 2, meaning bringing two things together is not just additive, right? There's something fundamentally that changes when you bring two things together, in this case, 3. And also creativity is about making connections. So this idea of linking things together and creating something new, I thought was a very powerful and relevant concept. But that was the extent of what my first brain was able to come up with. So what I found with Smart Connections is that it can give you all of the notes that it thinks has high relevancy, high degree of connection to your current note. So for this one, let me pick up a few interesting ones. Creativity is about using both sides of the brain, making connections between neurons, not just within one hemisphere. That's directly related to this creativity is about making connections. It also surfaces, this is another interesting one, that the two lightest elements combined to form one of the heaviest elements. So oxygen and hydrogen, both very light material, right? Both we put into balloons so that they could float. Actually, when you combine them together, they make water, H2O. And water is one of the heaviest substances, right? Whenever we're just drenched a little bit in the rain, we realize how much more effort we have to put in to just walk home. And so that's really fascinating to me that when you put two things together, you know, something completely different, something that fundamentally changes when there are chemical reactions. So not only can I add this into my connections, but I think one of the insights that I can come up with is that chemical reactions can cause fundamental change in property. I don't know if that's the best way to phrase this, but something like this. There is also, is there anything else? The source of creativity and innovation is cross-disciplinary thinking. So, you know, things like this, I won't go into the detail of every note here, but you get the idea. The plugin can help you surface notes that clearly I've forgotten about. So that is one way of making better connections with your notes. But that is only one of the things you can do. The other thing you can do is also to highlight specific passages in your note. Mine, this one is pretty short, so I didn't use that, but for notes that are really long and you're looking for connection to a specific part of the note, you can highlight it, go Control P or Command P and find smart connections, make smart connections, and the plugin will look for connections to that specific part of your note. The second thing you can do with the plugin is to chat with it. It's like ChatGPT, but it is answering your questions based on your notes, which is really fantastic. For example, you can say, summarize the key points from 2 square brackets. And let's say I want to find another note was a good one. Something about thinking. Maybe thinking 480p versus 4K. And let's say what it comes back with. It works just like ChatGPT, and you can leverage it to help you work on the private knowledge that you haven't yet uploaded onto the internet. So I'm really excited about this plugin. Let me show you how you can set this up. All right, come to Settings, Community Plugin, click Browse, and look for Smart Connections. Whoops. Smart Connections. And once you have that set up, click install. Mine is already installed. And come to options for the configuration. What you have to know is you need an OpenAI API key. You can do this by coming to the OpenAI website and then logging in and come to API. Once you're here, come to your account and click View API Keys. If you don't have any, there will be none here. You have to click Create New Secret Key, give it a name if you like, and create the secret key. Then you copy and paste this. Make sure you copy and paste it because you won't be able to view it again. And then go back to Obsidian and copy and paste it here. And click Test APIs. So if you have the free trial and there are already tokens on your account, then it'll work. You'll get a little notice up here saying API key is valid. If it doesn't work, that means you have to pay for it. Don't be alarmed. Pricing is not too scary. Okay, 750 words is 1,000 tokens, and 1,000 tokens is a few cents in US dollars. So if depending on which model you use, there will be different pricing. And let's say you use GPT 3.5 Turbo, then every time it reads through text, then 1,000 tokens will be 0.0015 or $0.003. And every time, let's say you chat with it and it gives you an output, then it's 0.002 cents for 1,000 tokens. So that's 750 words. And as they show up here, all of this text is 35 tokens. Now, if you're worried about this, what you can do is under billing, set usage limits. I also had the free trial. So up till now, I've used 20 cents out of my pocket. And you can set limits, soft limits. You know, when you reach this threshold, this dollar amount per month, they will send you an email and then it will stop accepting any more queries if you go over the hard limit. So you can set this as small as possible. I mean, I can set this $5 and set this, I don't know, $10 a month. And you know you will never go over that $10 a month. Coming back to Obsidian, once you have this and once you've tested, you can choose which language model you want to use. I'm using 3.5 Turbo 16K. This seems to be the fastest. Maybe once GPT-4 is less limited, I'll use that. But so far, 3.5 works just fine. And you can choose different languages, which is awesome. Right now, they're mostly Western languages. Let's see what happens in the future. Okay. Then, exclusions. So these are the files that you don't want the plugin to read. For files, you can exclude any file you don't want the plugin to read here. The only one I've added is actually a file that's created by this plugin, so it doesn't have to read through everything again. You can also exclude folders, so I'm getting it to exclude my templates and my Excalibur folders. You can set up more or less, just separate them by comma. And display, you can do a few things. If you like an expanded view of all the notes, you can toggle that on. I actually don't like it. I think it's too cluttered. So I close it and I only have the view open and the chat open. The first time around, you'll see there, they will ask you to create the embeddings.json file. So just click on that. Depending on how big your vault is, it might take some time. That's totally normal. But once it's finished looking through all of your notes, then you can use it just as we described. Let me know in the comments if this is something you want to try, and check out this video here for more of that first brain to second brain connection making. I'll see you in the next video. Bye!